Hey, Don back. Okay, well, it's been 30 minutes, a little about probably about 35 minutes. I ran it, broke it in. The compressor, that is, that's what I'm talking about. The previous video, I got it out of the box, put the wheels and the handle on it, and then I had to run it with an air coupler. That's a little warm. With it in there, wide open. And I had to put in my, I didn't stay out here the whole time just to fiddle around at all out of here and come back and forth. I had to have earplugs, man. So I knew it was going to be too loud for me. Of course, it won't normally be running for 30 minutes straight, but I knew it would be too loud, so I actually got lucky and had a couple of big cardboard, shipping boxes, Walmart boxes that, one or the other may fit right in there and make me hopefully blocks, knock down some of that noise. So I'm gonna get my air hose hooked up first. That's my old compressor over there. I don't know how much of it you can see. Well, it's in a wagon. Let's go ahead and unplug it. I'm gonna plug it in a little differently anyway. I'm gonna want to still be able to plug the old one in. But also, going to see if I'm aimed to where you can see at all what's going on down here. Yeah, you can. So I won't re-aim it again. Well, let's do that. There's no sense in showing a bunch of the area where I'm not doing anything. That light, sun's coming out of the trees, man. But the first thing I want to do is get this hose off of here and get it over here. Let's see. I'm still making the video. I'm always worried about this thing shutting down. I guess I might as well quit worrying about it. If it works, it works, and if it don't, it doesn't. Okay. Doing is this hose is probably 25 foot long. It goes from that little compressor to this air tank. It's one of those portable air tanks, pretty good sizing. And then I only stretch out this hose unless I need to go even further, then I can drag this tank around. But I'm going to eliminate this tank, I think. If I keep running out of air on this one, it's an 8 gallon. It's a long skinny tank. That's a fat one. It looks like that one's probably 5 gallons, I'm gonna guess. I don't remember what it is if I, have what I have in the way of knowing what it is. Awesome. Let's see what I need to do with this humidity for you. that's good hose. This blue hose, I used to do maintenance on gas service stations and convenience stores when they first, back in 1975 to 78, when they first started converting full service stations into convenience stores, the only kind of gas station that you know about today. And we had a company in Texas, it's called Wichita Oil in Wichita Falls, Texas. Didn't drill for oil, they did, they were the Texaco jobber, they sold, they did the retail end of the Texaco gasoline. And I did maintenance on, I was young, I was 18 when I got hired, and I was trained to do all that stuff. Well, a guy named Rocky, who was Rocky Rocchio, the true and one and only Rocky. He didn't box. He taught me how to work on it. Now I'm not going to have the hose on there permanently, so maybe that one that I just went to so much trouble to get off, which it really is going to be easier to unscrew than like that anymore. Get me some connected. I think that'll fit. That little valve can be handy. I've used it on and off. I don't need a valve here, I just need a quick couple. Yeah, I've got one, but it's pretty beat up. Figure out which one I think might be better menu. Oh, that's not the case. Well, I gotta get it off and see what fits it. I'm not sure if I need a male or a female or what. Okay, so yeah, as far as the I want to call it a barbed, but it's kind of barbed hose. You know? Sure, maybe that's what it is. Anyway, I got to get a wrench to get that off. You know? These are ratchet pin wrenches. They're pretty cool. sure everything will blow on. I always go back and forth. Actually, you can't do a lot of things with gloves on. I just, my hands are soft nowadays, and I don't like to cut them up. And to be honest, I don't like getting my hands dirty anymore. It's like all the little boys on the other YouTube videos. When I was back in those days, oh, you didn't use gloves. Be a man and use your hand. That's not what that is. Every time you use gloves is when you had to, you're working with chemicals, or you really might cut yourself up a little bit. You're supposed to have calluses to protect your hands. And then you can actually do stuff. So I go back and forth. I use gloves and then I take them off because I can't do anything. I'm holding this up in the air like I think you can see it in the video, and I just realized the video. Don't go that. This isn't even going. They don't fit. Too big. That means they need a bushing. Let's see if it matters. If I can tell. The brand new one here would be better or the old one. That click connector is quick. I'd say that this one's got a lot of, you know, kind of age on it, let's say. So I'm going to try a new one. I think I'm moving that seal in there better. Once you get pressure on it. But I definitely need a female. The problem is, I've got to have a size change. This one fits. Even though it looks terrible, it doesn't make it not work. So let me get make sure the threads on the battery. See? Yeah, that's alright. Hung the threads up a little bit. Because this one has smaller and they're not. Yeah, they're fine threads, and I would really, that probably needs to stay in there. I wasn't thinking. I saw this one and I thought, oh, it's so good. And then I kept having a feeling about it. And now I realize it is actually the only one I've got that'll work in this, right in this situation. Get a little tape off of there, make sure the threads don't have anything else. I can't see. Good. It's been used for a long time. Not like it's not going to happen again, real quick. That old white tank over there got a lot of rust in it over the years, you know, get water in it. The only way I could drain it is turn it up, pick it up, turn it upside down. So I was kind of didn't do it super often. Let's see. I think I'll put them together now and then put it into the hose. I'm sure it's going to fit the hose. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, that hose, that blue hose, was not considered a good hose back then. It kept getting little pinholes in it. It was in one of our, we're using them at our service stations. They were brand new. And we would buy them pre-fitted, you know, with ends on them and just replace them when they had a problem with their hoses. And they kept getting pinholes in them, but, you know, they were brand new. And they're real stiff, too. They're a pain in the butt to mess with. That was the biggest complaint. The first complaint was that they were driving the people, everybody crazy at the gas station. So we ended up having to replace them because they started getting pinholes on them real quick. And what I do, you know, is cut them. I cut the pinholes out and keep the good part. So I got to keep. I ended up getting heat. Probably about. 30 feet of it or something. Oh yeah, that does not, it won't work. That's so messed up. But that's why I always grab my, well, I'll start with the, that's why I always grab my baby vice grips. Always have them handy. Down there, so I won't lose it. Let's see. If I go in there easy, then I won't. Yeah, it's going to be okay. This hose looks like it's okay. I think it's just fine. But this hose has lasted from 1976, I'm going to say, till 2019, and it's still. And it hasn't been getting pinholes in it. I've never had that problem. Maybe I'm thinking of another hose because I actually haven't had this thing get a pinhole in it. I've been using it. It's been on my compressor for 10 years probably. Laid around the garage and, you know, seldom got used at all for many, many years. I've used it for this and that. I put gasoline in them. I'm using the siphon gasoline. All kinds of stuff. I have some more red rubber hose somewhere. I think I used most of it up. See, what I was thinking about is if I need extra air tank capacity, I'll run a short hose, because there's a piece, well, this piece right here would be perfect. It's really, see, it's only so long, and it's only 5-6 feet long, and I could put it between here and here. I'm not going to do it now, because I want to see if it'll do all right all by itself, but if I might, yeah, I'll just run this between here and here, and then that, with that other rest of the blue hose, probably 15-20 feet, and then that 25-foot orange hose, and then this one is 20 feet or 25 feet. I can still get, I'd like to be able to get out to the street to air up all the tires. Of course, this can be rolled around. I've got a 50-foot 20-amp cord over there that I can use, so yeah. So yeah, I can. But I'm not going to connect this to that tank unless I need to, because I'd actually rather leave it connected to the old air compressor. Well, somebody just got here, so I'm not. I have somebody coming by. that thing. Just about to get hook it back up. I haven't got it broke in.
Yeah.
So I'll turn it on. I'll turn it on and see if it looks like it'll do anything.
Yeah.
Boy, it's loud. I'm gonna see if I can.
Really?
Yeah. I knew it said it did 85 dB. These little ones are always like that. These oilless ones. So, of course, it won't run all the time, but I'm gonna see if I can put a roll it up in a box. Try to help that. I mean, it's bad. I'll plug it in a second. So, what'd you end up getting?
I only got the little ones.
$230. Maybe they'll do the trick. But
come in handy, all of them work.
Yeah.
It depends on how bad it is.
Yeah, what kind of situation you got.
I mean, you usually don't need them unless it's bad.
Yeah, okay, yeah, we're still recording, so yeah, well, I'm gonna try out an impact wrench. Okay, get ready to see how loud it is. Where are we? Okay, I'm a little low now. We're way lower than I realized. All right. I'm going to turn it on. Here's that. It was all tangled up. Sorry, it took me forever. That's 150. That's 150. Now I'm going to turn down to 125 on the output.
much different than that other one.
Is it? I didn't know standing right here by.
Golly.
Yeah, way louder than you'd expect. Boy, it'll do 150, pump up fast. 150, and then I'll set it on 125. I don't. If you had a good impact, you might end up using 150, but it's gonna like run out of air pretty quick because it's just only an 8 gallon tank. But it was $115,
yeah,
and it'll fit under here, place that I had. So
it's better than a pancake.
Yeah, I thought I was hoping it would be. It looked like it would be. I think it is. Definitely 150 pounds instead of 125 or 30 or 5 what the other ones do. Some of those pickups only do 135. Most of them.
I kind of read up on it one time. It's not the PSI, it's a CF something.
CF film? Yeah, it's 4.1. Just enough to run and impact intermittently, but not like all, you know. It's not good for a weak shopper.
Right.
You give it a few hits and then wait. Yeah. That's what I saw in the reviews.
Good run a nail gun.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And one guy did, there was only two videos on it, and one kid was painting his car with it, doing great. Of course, that'll paint. He paint all day with that. You only need 25 to 40 pounds of paint and stuff. With that tank. Now, it wouldn't do it without that tank. That's the key I figured out. That little old thing is nothing without that tank. You can't blow yourself off. Because you've got to have some reserve.
Yeah.
Know? So, and if I do get to where I keep one out on the air, I couldn't run this. That's already a short piece running to that tank, and I just don't want to do that if I don't have to, because I don't want them all that chained together, you know. But hopefully it'll be all right.
For no more than you've been using for, that's probably the perfect thing.
It's perfect, yeah. Okay, well, I'm just going to be fiddling around with it, trying to put a box in there and all that. I'm going to try to push a box up in there and slide it up in the box so much of that noise won't come out. So there we go. I think it's going to be all right. That impact wrench was no good. It was $5 yard sale impact wrench. I've got one that's doing the same thing. It just blows air and it won't turn. So supposedly you can take them apart and make them work again, but... the one I got's only 240 foot-pounds, and that other one's probably not. Might be three or 400. I saw it was a cobalt. And the one I got's an old 20-year-old Campbell Hossfield, and it's 240 foot-pounds. I found the manual on it. But I'm going to try to get me one that does like 800 foot-pounds. That's why I got this one that'll do 150 pounds of pressure. And 4.1 CFM, which is just enough to kind of get a good hammer and then wait, you know. But not too bad, I don't think, because it airs up fast. Anyway, I'm going to go for now.